to have less birthdays than anybody. Give it up for Jared Watt.
Everybody. So that's what happened 30 years after the Breakfast Club to John Bender. You know what? I respect everybody that's going to get up on this stage tonight, okay? Because being a comedian is so hard. Right? Give it up to you guys. Yeah. Come on, turn it out. Give it an open mic. Right? I'm 16 years old doing stand-up comedy. All these people that, you know, they're old, they have to worry about so many things, like their wives, their kids, finances. I'm 16. The worst thing I have to worry about is my parents seeing my search history. But you know what? I am on this stage. I am chasing my dreams, mostly the wet ones. What I'm starting to find out is being a comedian's a lot like being homeless. You know? Nobody tells you to do it. You only make money if you're super entertaining. And worst of all, when your parents find out, they're extremely disappointed in you. I don't get along with my mom. We're always fighting, you know, we're always getting into arguments. She's always trying to put me down. It's true, I have an appointment at the veterinarian next Wednesday. I got into a really bad accident on my bike. It's a Trek. a couple months ago, and I started arguing with the lady that hit me, you know, because it was pretty rough. Like, I could have died, right? And we're going back and forth. I go, lady, can you not read the sign? It says, drive like your kids live here. She goes, I was. So I go, mom. I don't know. I'm always getting into arguments with my parents about stupid things. Like, there were these new Nikes I wanted the other day, right? You know, it's a stupid thing. And then I got really upset about it, and I just locked myself in the bathroom crying. And I turned on YouTube, and this, I feel like this is the universe speaking to me. The first thing I see on YouTube is just an ad for a poor Make-A-Wish kid. This makes me feel horrible, you know, it really makes you sad. It's like, that poor kid. He could have used his wish to get those Nikes. It was a rough winter. My grandma passed away. No, it's cool. Now I can afford college. She left behind a ton of things I want to keep. She left one thing behind I don't want to keep. My dad. Give it up for my dad. He's in the audience. Dad, put your hands up. Put it up for him. Come on. My dad's a huge alcoholic. he did something really bold. He went to AA this week. You know, he's been 7 days sober, but now I'm seeing a white claw on the table. So that is that. So, Mark, did you see that Cocaine Bear movie? What's next? Heroin Shark? I mean, I don't know. They're actually making a movie now called Alcoholic Parents. This is true. This is true. That's the sequel. And it's about these two parents that go on a drunken rampage, driving naked through their town, proceeding to kill a rabbi, a nun, and a priest, and worst of all, an entire troop of 7-year-old Girl Scouts. And believe this, just like Cocaine Bear, it's actually a biopic. It's called My Parents. All right, well, I just ruined my dad's birthday. Good night, everybody. Give it up for Jared.